So when it comes to managing finances, we automatically think of adulthood. But my guest now is on the line to share that we should be schooling our children on the business of budgeting as soon as possible. She is the FNDR of Kids Who Bank, Jetali Belanton, FNDR. What does that mean? Financial? What does that mean, Jetali?
Founder.
Oh, I knew that. Okay, they put it in caps on the prompter. I was like, FNDR, founder. Got it. Good to talk to you. You're currently in the US, correct?
Yes, I am. I'm in New York.
Okay, but you've lived in the UK. You've done work in Ghana, and you have Jamaican heritage. So there's a lot of different aspects to who you are. Tell me a little bit about the motivation for teaching children financial literacy, because it's not really a thing. I mean, we hear more people talking about it now, but generally we haven't really talked about that.
Yes. So I worked in finance for 13 and a half years, and I worked for some of the richest people. And it didn't matter how rich my clients were. They could have been multimillionaires, half a billionaire, and they seem to also have this issue of budgeting. And when I noticed that, it didn't matter how rich a person was, they had issues with budgeting. And then, you know, people in lower economic backgrounds have issues with budgeting. It just really made sense to me that we needed to start teaching our children from a younger age how to budget and how to understand what a credit score is and how to create their own businesses and actually thrive financially. So when I had my son, who's now 5, but when I first had my son, I took that as a motivation to create a platform that could teach him as well as teach other youth. And that's honestly how it started. It's really just wanting to see our people do better, especially when it came to budgeting and not being financially poor or breaking that generational curse.
And that is a problem in our community. I know we have organizations in Jamaica like Junior Achievement who have set up a little like a business area for kids who work as kid CEOs and bankers and so on, giving them experience. And I remember when I was back in baby school, we used to have like bank books introduced and they used to encourage us to save. How do you in 2020 relay that message to a 5-year-old like your son or to other children? How do you teach them about that so that it resonates and they understand?
So honestly, people forget that at 5 years old, even at 2 years old, a lot of our youth have requests. So they're very comfortable telling you, mommy, I don't like that apple juice. I like this apple juice. Mommy, I want porridge. Mommy, I want, they have a list of requests. I want a scooter. I want a bicycle. So when you talk to a child at that age and they're making these requests, then that's when you can start teaching them how to budget, how to earn what they want. So, you know, even my son, he loves Hot Wheels cars. So when we go to the supermarket, every time he would want a Hot Wheels car. So eventually got to the point where we would tell him, well, you know what? You have to earn it. So every night he would clean up his toys and then he would earn a quarter towards purchasing his Hot Wheels car at the end of the week, which is $1.25. And so by the time the week came, he not only learned how to earn the money, but then we as parents reinforced it when we went to the supermarket. If he didn't earn enough money to buy the Hot Wheels car, when he asked us for it, we say, well, you didn't clean up your toys this whole
week. Correct.
You don't have enough money. So then after the second time that happened to him, for the last 2-3 years, he consistently always cleans up after himself. So since the age of 2-3 years old, he's been cleaning up his toys every night. Even when we go away and we're like in a hotel or something, he still cleans up after himself before going to bed because, you know, that's how he earns his toys.
So
that's just one example.
Beyond financial literacy, you're teaching him discipline and you're teaching him responsibility.
True.
So there are some added benefits, value-added benefits that, you know, they don't hurt, don't tell.
Very true, very true. And honestly, our kids are little humans. So even when it comes to budgeting, let's say if you're saving up to buy a house, and your kid has all these expensive things they want to get. I want a pair of Jordans or expensive sneakers and all of these things, or I want an iPad. Well, you could create a chart board, even if it's a teenager, and put it on like the fridge somewhere local that they can really see what's happening. And from there, you could have them be involved in the saving process to buy the house. So then the child now is more responsible. So maybe instead of buying a $100 pair of sneakers, they'll buy a $40 pair of sneakers, because now they're realizing, you know what, the goal is to buy a house so they can maybe have a bigger bedroom or even have a bedroom. So you now include them in the saving process and basically make them little adults. So it also shows them, besides discipline, but it also shows them teamwork, mm-hmm. you know? So I think it's just beautiful. We're in a new phase when it comes to our youth.
Yeah, and there's an empowerment in that as well. So am I supposed to understand that you've, because of what you're trying to do in this area, you've left your corporate job? Is that correct?
Yes, I did. So I left corporate, honestly, because I wanted to be a hands-on mother. And so that was originally my catalyst reason for leaving corporate, but I always thought I was going to go back. But now, a couple of years later, realistically, that's not happening.
Not
and
doing
the
it.
That's going to happen is because, you know, our finance curriculum has gone into 217 schools nationwide around the U.S. We went into 4 schools internationally, you know, between Australia and Africa, Ghana and Kenya and U.K. And honestly, I can't even imagine going back to a regular 9-to-5 because I feel like I've been more effective in this position, helping people, helping my community, teaching adults and parents, you know, from all different backgrounds, financial literacy.
That's it, so great, because now what you're doing is planting that seed to make sure that future generations are better off. And there is no better reward than that, I'm sure.
100%. Yeah. I agree. I fully agree.
Fantastic.
You know, there's no money that could take this away. Like, to me, this is the best part.
Well, keep on doing it. We're glad you started. And thank you for making a difference, Jatale. We appreciate having you on this morning to share with us. Founder of Kids Who Bank, Jatale Belantan, with us on Smile. We'll be right back after this.
Thank you.